Hello dear students, this is Murali from St. Mary's College, Shirvan. In the last class, we have completed with problem number 1 on the determination of eligibility of a person who wish to opt for composition levy. Now we are moving to problem number 2. Kindly write the problem number 2. Problem number 2. Mr. Vivek, a dealer in Karnataka, furnishes the following details for the year 2019-20. Furnishes the following details, for the year 2019-20, for the year 2019-20. Okay, first one, compute aggregate turnover. And state whether he is eligible for composition levy and state whether he is eligible for composition levy under GST law. Full stop. If so, calculate tax liability. Next slide, one by one. First one, sold goods to Mr. X of Chamarajanagar for rupees 5 lakhs. Okay. Sold goods to Mr. X of Chamarajanagar rupees 5 lakhs. Okay, that's the first one. Second one, sold goods to Mr. Y in Mandya. Rupees 2 lakhs. Next one. Sold goods to XYZ company in Bangalore for rupees 1 lakh 50,000. Okay. Next one, goods received from unregistered dealer rupees 10,000. Next one is goods received from unregistered dealer rupees 10,000. Next, fifth one, goods supplied to a job worker in Mysore. Rupees 1 lakh 50,000. And received after completion. Next at the sixth one, supply of services to Mr. B for rupees 4 lakhs. Supply of services to Mr. B for rupees 4 lakhs. At zero rate under GST. Okay. Next one. Write the seventh one. Sale of goods to a merchant in Mysore. Seventh one is sale of goods to a merchant in Mysore, rupees 5 lakhs. Okay. Next one, eighth one, transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to a branch in Bangalore. Rupees 5 lakhs. Okay. Next, ninth one. Imported goods worth rupees 8 lakhs. Next one, tenth one. Purchased goods from Hyderabad. For rupees 10 lakhs. Okay. And the next one, 11th one. Supplied goods from his branch at Mandya, rupees 5 lakhs. Okay, that's the problem. First we need to calculate aggregate turnover. Then on the basis of the aggregate turnover, we should determine whether he is eligible for composition levy or not. Okay, that is firstly on the basis of aggregate turnover. Okay, so aggregate turnover is not only the criteria to determine the composition levy, it's a basic condition. Basic criteria is aggregate turnover. So after that we have to see whether the aggregate turnover or whether the person is engaged in the supply of the any non-eligible supplies. Okay, so we will start with the solution. Write the heading solution computation of aggregate turnover of Mr. Vivek. Computation of aggregate turnover of Mr. Vivek. Okay. One second, dear students. Yes, sorry for the disturbance. So we need to calculate the aggregate turnover. So write the heading computation of aggregate turnover of Mr. Vivek. Aggregate turnover of Mr. Vivek. Only two columns are enough, particulars and the amount column. Okay, particulars and amount column. Okay, so at the time of calculating aggregate turnover, we should concentrate only on the calculation of aggregate turnover. Okay, so we will calculate aggregate turnover as per section 2, subsection 6 of the CGST Act 2017. Okay, so aggregate turnover as per section 2, subsection 6 of the CGST Act, it includes taxable supplies, exempted supplies, and export of goods and services, and also interstate supplies, but excluding the value of inward supplies on which tax is paid under reverse charge mechanism. So tax paid under reverse charge mechanism, that means inward supplies are to be excluded at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. Now we will see one by one. Okay, Mr. Vivek, our dealer in Karnataka, furnished the following details for the year 2019-20. First, we need to calculate the aggregate turnover. On that basis, we should determine whether he is eligible or not. So if he is eligible, okay, so we need to calculate the tax liability only if he is eligible for composition levy. Only if he is eligible for composition levy. And okay, and this question that is we are working now, that is asked in the year 2018 for 12 marks. So it is a very important question from the point of view of your semester examination. Okay, so first one, see the first transaction, sold goods to Mr. X of Chamrajnagar. Okay, so sold is now the Mr. Vivek has sold goods to Mr. X of Chamrajnagar. So Mr. Vivek is a dealer in Karnataka and he sold goods to Mr. X of Chamrajnagar. Even Chamrajnagar is also in Karnataka. So it is a intrastate supplies. Okay, so intrastate supplies are the part of aggregate turnover. Okay, because we cannot say which kind, whether it is taxable or exempted, or whether it is taxable supplies. We cannot classify because we don't know the goods. What is actually the goods, that is not known. So, but for the purpose of calculating aggregate turnover, we should include all kind of supplies except inward supplies. Write the first one, sold goods to Mr. X of Chamrajnagar. Okay. First one, sold goods to Mr. X of Chamrajnagar. So value is 5 lakh rupees. Okay, value of supply is 5 lakh rupees. Okay, next one, sold goods to Mr. Y in Mandya. So it is also intrastate supply. So intrastate supplies are the part of aggregate turnover. So it should be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. So next one is sold goods to Mr. Y in Mandya. Okay, sold goods to Mr. Y in Mandya. In Mandya. value of supply is rupees 2 lakhs. Okay, value of supply is rupees 2 lakhs. Okay. Next one is sold goods to XYZ company in Bangalore. So Bangalore is in Karnataka. Mr. Vivek is also from Karnataka. So it is an intrastate supply. Intrastate supplies are the part of aggregate turnover. So it should be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. Right. The next one, sold goods to XYZ company in Bangalore. Sold goods to XYZ company in Bangalore. Value of supply is rupees 1,50,000. Okay. Next, fourth one, goods received from unregistered dealer. It is a goods received. That means it is a goods purchased. It's a goods purchased. Inward supplies are not the part of aggregate turnovers. Okay. So he has purchased from an unregistered dealer. So as he has purchased from unregistered dealer, the person who is purchasing, that is Mr. Vivek, should pay the tax on the basis of reverse charge mechanism. So inward supplies are not the part of aggregate turnover as per section 2 subsection 6 of CGST Act. Okay, so that should not be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. Okay. Next one, goods supplied to a job worker in Mysore. Now the goods is been supplied to a job worker in Mysore. Okay, the value of the goods is rupees 1,50,000 and it has received after completion. Okay, we have to make this point very clearly. So it is not a supply, it is not the sale. Okay, so it is just a goods is been sent by the Mr. Vivek to a job worker in Mysore for the purpose of further processing. Final goods is not ready and the goods is not sold. Okay, and after processing it is being sent to Mr. Vivek. So it is not considered as a supply as per section 2 subsection 6 of CGST Act. That means it should not be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. Okay. Next one. Sixth one. Supply of services to Mr. B, rupees 4 lakhs at a zero rate under GST. Now actually what he is supplying? He is providing the service. Okay, the value of the service is rupees 4 lakhs. Actually, as we are calculating the aggregate turnover, we need to consider. But when we think about, composition levy is not applicable to the service providers. Okay, that we will think of later. First, we will calculate only the aggregate turnover as he is supplying the services. That is at the zero rate. That is, he is supplying the zero rated supplies. So even zero rated supplies are also the part of aggregate turnover as per section 2 subsection 6 of CGST Act. Right. The next one, Supply of services to Mr. B. Okay. So value of service is rupees 4 lakhs. Value of the service is 4 lakhs. Okay. Next one. Seventh one. Sale of goods to merchant in Mysore. So it's a sale. Mysore is in Karnataka. Vivek is also from Karnataka. So it is a intrastate supply. Intrastate supplies are the part of aggregate turnover. Next one, right? Sale of goods to merchant in Mysore. Value of supply is 5 lakhs rupees. Next one, transfer of goods. Next one is, okay, we have to see the sentence very clearly. Eighth one is the transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to a branch in Bangalore. Whether it should be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover or not. That's the question. So it's a transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to a branch in Bangalore for rupees 5 lakhs. Okay. As per section 7, subsection 1 of the CGST Act, that specifies or that defines the supply. Okay, supply includes sale, transfer, exchange, barter, and the lease and disposal. If it is made or agreed to be made for a consideration by a person in the course or furtherance of business. So in the definition of supply, even transfer is also included. In the definition of supply, when transfer is also included, that is very clearly defined under section 7, subsection 1 of CGST Act. So we need to consider some transfer of goods also at the time of calculating aggregate turnover, right? The next one, transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to branch in Bangalore. Transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to branch in Bangalore. Okay, value of supply is 5 lakhs rupees. Okay, next one is the imported goods. It's a imported. Import means that we are purchasing, we are acquiring the goods. As per section 2, subsection 6 of the CGST Act, inward supplies should not be considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover. Okay, so that should be excluded now. Okay. Next one, purchased goods from Hyderabad. Now it's a purchase. Now it's an acquiring the goods. So inward supplies, same as compared to the point number nine. So earlier one was the import. Now it is from the Hyderabad. That is from the interstate. That is from the other state we are purchasing. So inward supplies are not the part of aggregate turnover as per section 2, subsection 6 of CGST Act. Next, 11th one, supplied goods from his branch at Mandya. He has supplied a goods value of rupees 5 lakhs. Okay, even if the goods is supplied from his branch also, that should be considered for the calculation of aggregate turnover. Next one, right? Supplied goods from his branch at Mandya, 5 lakhs rupees. So all the transactions are over. Now we can make the total. You can make the total 5 lakhs plus 2 lakhs plus 1 lakh 50,000 plus 4 lakhs plus 5 lakhs plus 5 lakhs. Then again 5 lakhs rupees. That is the last one, is the supplied goods from this branch at Mandya. Total, now the answer is 27 lakh 50,000. What is this answer? Answer is the aggregate turnover. Now the aggregate turnover is rupees 27 lakh 50,000. Okay, that we have calculated. Okay, so this is a basic condition for determining the eligibility. For determining the eligibility of a person who wish to opt for composition levy is the aggregate turnover. Okay, the persons dealer who have an aggregate turnover of rupees less than 1.5 crores are eligible to opt for composition levy. Are eligible to opt for composition. That is the first condition. So aggregate turnover is rupees 27,50,000. That is less than 1.5 crores. As per aggregate turnover, he is eligible. But there are certain other conditions are that deals with the non-eligible surplus. So from the aggregate turnover, we have to find out whether the Mr. Vivek is engaged in the supply of non-eligible supplies means if he is engaged in the supply of services, okay, or if he has engaged in the supply of non-GST goods like petroleum products, alcohol, liquid for human consumption, electricity are the non-GST goods. Then interstate supplies, and we have to find out whether he is a casual taxable person or whether he is a non-resident taxable person. It is very clearly stated. He is a dealer. He is not a casual taxable person. He is not a non-resident casual taxable person. And he is also not, whether he is involved in the e-commerce operation. No, he is not involved in the e-commerce operation. And we have to find out whether he is a manufacturer of the tobacco products, pan masala and ice cream. That everything we have to consider. Okay, before giving interpretation, we need to identify whether the Mr. Vivek, whether the dealer is engaged in the supply of the non-eligible supplies. Okay, so now identify. First one is the sold goods to Mr. X in Chamarajanagar. That is eligible. So Chamarajanagar is in Karnataka. Okay, only interstate outward supplies are not allowed. Chamarajanagar is in Karnataka, so it is allowed. Okay, second one is sold goods to Mr. Y in Mandya. Mandya is also in Karnataka, so it is allowed. Okay, next, sold goods to XYZ company in Bangalore. Bangalore is in Karnataka, so it's a intrastate supply. It is allowed. Why I am telling intrastate supply? Because this composition levy is exclusively meant for intrastate supply. There are certain exceptions in case of interstate supply. It is not applicable to, actually composition levy is not applicable to interstate supply, but there are certain exceptions. Okay. So next one is the goods received from unregistered dealer. Okay, so this we need to calculate. The goods received from unregistered dealer we have not considered at the time of calculating aggregate turnover, as it is the inward supply. Okay, and there is no clarification regarding whether the goods is purchased from within the state or whether the goods is purchased from outside the state. And one thing is very clear, it is purchased from the unregistered dealer. Okay, on the purchase of goods, the person who is purchasing, here the person is Mr. Vivek, so he has to pay the tax. He has to pay the input tax. And now the question is whether he is purchased from unregistered dealer within the state or whether he is purchased from unregistered dealer outside the state. Okay, if he has purchased from outside the state, that is from the unregistered dealer, he is not. Mr. Vivek is not eligible for composition levy because he is not supposed to purchase from unregistered dealer. Section 9, subsection 4 of the CGST Act deals with the reverse charge mechanism. That is specifically purchase from the unregistered dealer. That he has purchased from the unregistered dealer of the outside the state, at that time he is not eligible for composition levy. Because if he is capable of purchasing from outside the state, means he is having so much money. He's having so much money. So as he is having so much money, so why the composition levy should be given to Mr. Vivek? That's the question. That's the argument from the government. So it is this composition levy is specifically meant for intrastate supply. And here, as it is not clearly stated in the problem whether it's a purchase within the state or whether it is a purchase from outside the state, it is assumed that he has purchased from within the state, from the Karnataka itself. So he is eligible. On that condition, no problem to the Mr. Vivek for claiming a composition levy. But that is not only the solution. There are certain other transactions are there. After analyzing every transaction, we will come to one conclusion. Okay. Before, by seeing one transaction, we cannot give conclusion. We have to analyze all the transactions. Then at the final, we will give the conclusion whether he is eligible for composition levy or not. Okay. So next one is some good supply to the job worker. So actually that we have not taken for the aggregate turnover. Next one is supply of service. Okay, so this is a very important point. Okay, under the non-eligible supplies, even supplies of service also comes. So this composition levy is exclusively applicable to the suppliers of goods. Okay, exclusively applicable to the suppliers of goods. Here he has supplied service. Okay. Condition number one, as per in the non-eligible supply, is the suppliers of service other than restaurant service. Okay, so this for the suppliers of restaurant services, it is applicable, but to all other suppliers, it is not applicable. But one new provision is been added to the section 10 of the CGST Act that deals with the composition scheme. CGST Act, even manufacturers and the traders can also opt for composition levy even if they supply services also provided. Value of such service should not exceed 10% of the turnover in the preceding financial year or 5 lakh rupees, whichever is more. Okay, what is the turnover in the preceding financial year? Preceding financial year turnover we don't know. Okay, it's 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is more. Okay, as the preceding financial year's turnover is known, we cannot calculate the 10% of preceding financial year's turnover. So, or 5 lakh rupees. Now, the value of the service. So, what's the value of service? Value of service is rupees 4 lakhs. Okay, so 4 lakh is less than 5 lakh rupees. 4 lakh is less than 5 lakh rupees. So, when it is less than the 5 lakh rupees, such supply of service is eligible for composition levy. Okay, so there is no problem with this transaction, supply of service. Okay, so next we have to see the next transaction also. Okay, next one, sale of goods to merchant in Mysore. It is allowed. It's an interstate supply. Then transfer of goods from branch in Mandya to branch in Bangalore. So it is a interstate supply. Okay. Then imported goods worth rupees 8 lakhs and one more is there, purchased goods from Hyderabad. Okay, so this gives a problem. Okay, we can, because it is an interstate, as per section 10 of the CGST Act, it is very clearly stated that interstate supplies are not eligible for a composition levy. But one provision is been added. Under section 9 subsection 3 and section 9 subsection 4 of the CGST Act. Here is an information regarding purchase of goods from Hyderabad and import of goods from outside the country. But it is not clearly stated whether it is from the registered person or whether it is from the unregistered person. Okay, so what the section 9 subsection 3 and section 9 subsection 4 of CGST Act says. Okay, section 9 section 9 subsection 3 and section 9 subsection 4 deals with the reverse charge mechanism. Both are deals with the reverse charge mechanism. Okay, then what the section 9 subsection 3 states? Okay, if the this means if the supplier purchases goods from registered person, if the supplier purchases the goods from registered person, that is the notified list of goods and services. Notified list of goods and services. Notified list of goods and services, and he has purchased that, supplier purchased the goods, notified list of goods and services, and he paid the tax on reverse charge mechanism. Okay, paid the tax on reverse charge mechanism. So with this situation, in this situation he is eligible. That's what we have explained in the last class. Okay, in the last, he is eligible for composition levy. Okay, but in this problem there is no clarification regarding whether he is purchased from the registered person or whether he has purchased from the unregistered person. Okay, and even if he has purchased from the registered person, whether he has purchased the notified list of goods and services, that is also not specified. Actually, it should be specified. It is not specified, and that is one. Then whether he has paid the tax, that is also not specified. If he has paid the tax, that he should pay the tax on the basis of reverse charge mechanism, then he is eligible for composition levy. With regard to import, it is an import from the foreign supplier. It is an import of goods and services from the foreign supplier. So it is very clearly stated under section 2 subsection 77 of the CGST Act. So he is a non-resident taxable person. Okay, import means is a person in outside the country is supplying goods to the person in India. Before supplying goods, 5 days prior to the commencement of business, or 5 days prior to the providing service or provide supplying goods, he should register himself in the India. He should register India, that is in the state where he is going to provide the service or where he is going to provide the supply the goods. Okay, so he should register, that is not the problem, but it is not clearly stated in the problem whether he is purchased from the registered person or he is purchased from the unregistered person. Okay, next, so we can make the assumption he has purchased from the registered person. We can make the assumption that he has purchased from the registered person and he has purchased the notified list of goods. And he has paid the tax under reverse charge mechanism. Okay, with that assumption, if we make that assumption, we can say that he is eligible for composition levy. And we can make the one more assumption also, that is in the section 9 subsection 4. What the section 9 subsection 4 says, that is the purchase of goods from unregistered dealer, because it is not specified in this problem whether it is from registered or whether it is from unregistered. So section 9 and subsection 4 states that purchase of goods and services from unregistered dealer. So as he has purchased from unregistered dealer, he should pay the tax on the basis of reverse charge mechanism. But if he pay the tax also, he is not eligible for composition levy. We can make this assumption also. Okay, so we have to specify while writing the interpretation whether he is eligible for composition levy or not. We have to specify both the assumption. If you specify, you are the expert students. Okay, otherwise it is confusing. Because why I am saying this? Because actually it is to be specified very clearly. Whether it is a purchase from registered dealer, whether it is a purchase from unregistered dealer. Okay, because the confusion is the interstate supplies are not allowed for composition levy. Actually, clearly saying interstate supplies are not eligible for composition levy. But one provision is been given under section 9.3 and under section 9 subsection 4 it is given. That's with regard to reverse charge mechanism. Reverse charge mechanism. But even that is also not specified. Even that is also not specified. But we need to. But while writing interpretation, we have to clarify these things. You will get full marks. You will get full marks. Okay. Next is regarding the supplied goods from our branch at Mandya. So it's the intrastate supply. It is eligible. It is eligible. Next line you write the interpretation. First assumption is that the import of goods and services, import of goods from the outside the state and purchase of goods from Hyderabad is from registered person and he has purchased the notified list of goods and services and he paid the tax under reverse charge mechanism. That is the first assumption. So at that case he is eligible for composition levy. So if he is eligible, he need to pay the tax. Okay, that is we need to calculate tax liability. Okay, interpretation number one, since aggregate turnover of rupees 27,50,000 is less than 1.5 crores, Mr. Vivek is eligible for composition levy. And in the bracket you have to specify. It is assumed that purchase of goods from Hyderabad, because Hyderabad is in Telangana, so it's a purchase from other state. Actually interstate supply is not allowed, but we are making the assumption here the person who has supplied the goods is registered. On behalf of the registered person, he is paying the tax because he wants to apply for composition levy. So we need to give the assumption. It is assumed that purchase of goods from Hyderabad and import of goods from outside the state. Are purchased as per section 9 subsection 3. It is only enough. Because section 9.3, what does mean by section 9.3? Section subsection 3 means what? Section 9 subsection 3 means purchase of goods from the registered person, that is a notified list of goods and services, and he paid the tax also. Person who is purchasing has paid the tax under reverse charge mechanism. Section 9.3. The one section itself is an indication of entire sentence. Okay, so that need not be written. If it required, you can write that. Okay, if required, you can write that. So as is, okay. It is stated here, he is eligible for composition levy. So as he is eligible composition levy, we need to calculate tax liability. Next right, below that line you calculate computation of tax liability. Only two columns, one column particulars, and the column for maintaining rupees. Okay, first one, tax liability. What is the tax liability? He is not engaged in the restaurant services. So it is assumed that he is a manufacturer or the trade up. So manufacturers are taxed at the rate of 1%. Are taxed at the rate of 1%. So as this composition levy is exclusively applicable to intrastate supply. So in case of intrastate supply, CGST and SGST are payable. So first one, CGST. CGST at zero. Actually, total rate of tax is 1%. In that, 0.5 is CGST, and the 0.5 is the SGST. Okay. Aggregate turnover is rupees 27,50,000. 27,50,000 into 0.5%. Right, calculate 27,50,000 into 0.5%. This is 13,750. CGST is 13,750, and SGST is also 13,750. Total tax payable, total tax liability is 27,500. Okay. Total tax liability is 27,500. Okay. This is because of the assumption that he has purchased the goods and service goods from Hyderabad, and he has imported the goods from outside the state as per section 9 subsection 3. It is because of that assumption. Okay. And we can make one more assumption also. You write the interpretation number two. It is assumed that purchase of goods from Hyderabad. Usually importer, the person who is exporting the goods, as I said, 5 days prior he should register as a non-resident taxable person. The person who supplies the goods usually register. So we cannot take the import here. Or we can write the import also, because they need not be registered also. But as per section 2 subsection 77, they should register 5 days prior to the commencement of business. You can write that also. So it is assumed that purchase of goods from Hyderabad and import of goods are made as per section 9 subsection 4. That is only enough. What does mean by subsection 9 subsection 4? That means purchase of goods from unregistered dealer. Okay, so as he has purchased from unregistered dealer, he has to pay the tax under reverse charge mechanism, but that purchase is not eligible for composition levy. Okay, Mr. Vivek is not eligible for composition levy. That's the interpretation. So it is better to write both the interpretation. You will not lose the marks. You will get full marks, because you are solving the problems according to the sections. What is specified under the sections, according to that we are solving. Okay, because my suggestion is that information should be very clear, because there is no information regarding whether it has purchased it from the registered person or unregistered person. So everything should be specified. and whether it has, she has purchased the notified list of goods and services, even that is also not clear. So we cannot give the interpretation but just by saying the purchase of goods from Hyderabad. Actually, it is an interstate. It is a interstate supply. It is specified under Section 10. Interstate supplies are not eligible for compulsion levy, but they have provided one provision, but there is no clarification regarding the provisions in the problem. So we have assumed in both the cases and we have written the interpretation, you will get the full marks. Okay, so I hope this problem is very clear to you all. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I will definitely help you to solve the your confusions. With this, I am concluding this session. We will meet you in the next class. Thank you.